Hello everybody, Coach Rex here. I guess everybody have heard the news that the World OCR Race, Virtual Race 3 registration is already open. So I hope you guys are already signed up and all set to do this race. Yeah, so I am anyway, so I'm gonna be attempting my race this weekend on Saturday. I'm not so sure about you guys, but I hope you guys are gonna plan for it soon. Okay, so with that, if you guys go to the website itself, you guys can actually see the race format. So what I'm actually going to be doing today is I'm going to help you guys out. So I know some of you guys have a bit of like uncertainty of how the movement should be done and stuff. So if you go to the website itself, there are actually videos on how this movement can be done. But there isn't much explanation except for if you go through the obstacle rules, they will actually put down, like say for the first one, the overhead presses, you are required to do 10 repetitions, you are supposed to be doing this particular weight if you are in the elite or the age group for men, stuff like that. Okay, so I am actually gonna help you guys out by actually performing these movements, and at the same time I'll probably give you guys the alternative movement that I believe can be done, because this is based on the rules itself. Okay, I'm not trying to find any loopholes here or whatsoever, but I'm just trying to see if I can actually help you guys out. Because, like I say, example, later on when I go through the movement, I will probably go through like a slightly detailed explanation to it. Okay, so as I said, I'm gonna try and keep this video as short as possible because I don't want to bore you guys with me yakking. So I try to do as much practical movement so that you guys can actually maybe practice this movement first on your own, and then hopefully on whatever race day that you guys choose to actually attempt this race, you guys can actually hopefully have a very smooth one. Okay, alright, so the next video you guys will see will be the first movement, the overhead press. The first obstacle I'm going to be covering is what they mentioned here as overhead press. So here's the thing, this particular obstacle, which is, they call it the overhead press, it's not the overhead press that most of you guys are familiar with. Okay, so it's actually, for some of you guys who are familiar, it's actually used mostly more like what we call the crown to overhead. Yeah, I know some of you guys practice this movement, some of you guys may not, but in any case, like I say, I'm going to show you guys. So anyway, the race format is all inside the website itself, go and check it out. Okay, so I'm just going to mention a few things. It says start with the weight on the crown. You can pull the weight and press overhead, one each hand simultaneously, and arm straight at the top. Okay, so I'm assuming that this person is actually referring to if you are using a dumbbell or any form of weight that is in a pair. Okay, you can also, it does mention that you can also use a single weight. Okay, so things like sandbag, backpack, barbells. Like myself, I have a kettlebell which I'm going to show you guys a variation of the kettlebell. So goal is weight should be starting from bottom, end up at the top with your arms straight at the top. Okay, if I put it in another term, everything should be locked out at the top. Okay, so let's not waste time, I'm going to show you guys how we are going to do this. So, as always, as remember, as mentioned, the weight will start from the bottom. So once you've done your first 100 meters, you come to the first checkpoint. The first station, what you're going to do is you're just going to reach down for the dumbbell. Okay, you're going to bring it up straight over your head. Okay, so this will be considered as one rep. So you're going to make sure you put the weight back down on the floor, touch, and then up. Okay, so touch, and then up. So every single time, make sure you lock out your elbows at the top. So this will make it a lot easier for whoever is verifying your video to count that as a rep. Okay, so just remember, every single time weight touches the floor and up. So you're gonna do a total of 10 repetitions. Once you're done, you put the weight down and then you continue with your run. Okay, so as I mentioned, please remember the weights that you are supposed to use here, depending on the category and your gender as well. So as I mentioned also, that's why they say you can use all sorts of equipment, whatever thing that you have. You just need to make sure you can verify the weight itself. Okay, so in my case, like I said, I'm just practicing today. This is a 7.5 kg. So all you need to do is basically just go to the camera, verify that this is a 7.5 kg dumbbell. Okay, so Alternatively, like I say, if you don't have much equipment, you only like happen to have just one kettlebell, okay? So take a look. This would be the variation that I would actually do with the kettlebell. Same thing, the requirement is weight has to start from the bottom. So you start from the bottom and then you have to bring the weight up over your head. Yeah. Okay. Every single time, make sure the weight touches the floor, elbows locked up at the top. So that is just me using a variation of using a kettlebell or empty form. Maybe some of you guys will have sandbags and stuff like that. Okay, there you go guys. The first station, the overhead press. So on to obstacle 2. Burpees, box, jump or step ups. Okay, so the very first thing that you need to do for this obstacle is you need to identify where you guys are going to be doing the step up again for the step up or the jump side. So in this case, I assume you guys can use anything. It does mention already you can use a step box, you can use a wall, a bench, anything that is actually 0.4 meters high. Okay, if you don't have to be exact, but to place it, just make sure it's slightly higher, because that would be probably the best thing to do. So in this case, once again, like I said, 0.4 meter or 16 inch. Okay, so the movement requirement is you've got to start with a burpees chest to the ground. This one everybody know, because most of you guys have done this before and you know that's the requirement, right? So chest to the ground, and then you're going to either jump up or step up. Make sure both feet is on top, and then you stand tall with your hands over your head. It doesn't mention about keeping your hands straight, but it just mentioned about your hands over your head. As long as your head is within your head, that's going to count. And then, in order for that to be counted as one rep, is when you actually step down. Okay, so you step down, both feet on the ground, then that is considered as one rep. And then you can repeat. Okay, so let's not waste time. Let me quickly show you guys how it will be done. Okay, so I'm just going to take two steps. Yeah? So I'm just going to land somewhere up here. Alright, so the first one, as mentioned, chest to the ground, burpees with your chest to the ground. It's simple, jump back, touch the ground. Okay, you don't have to release your hand, which is not what it mentioned inside the rules. So from here, you're just going to jump back forward and up. Step down, hands over your head. And then, you can either jump back down, or in my case, I just want to be safe, step back down. Okay, I will strongly encourage that you guys step back down, because you guys are going to be running, and I think by the time you hit your third or fourth set, your legs are going to feel like changing. So, to play safe, step down. Okay? So, that was me doing burpees, box jumps, so alternative movement, burpees to step up. Same thing. Down, chest to the ground. Okay? Jump back up, step up, hands over it, and then down. There you go. Okay? So, simple as that, just keep things as simple as possible. And remember once again, the jumping down portion, some of you guys are strong enough. I'm very confident that you guys will be able to jump down. But for some of you guys who are very, very, especially those of you guys with existing injuries and stuff, please take care of yourself. My suggestion is step down. Alright, there you go. This is obstacle 2. Okay, so obstacle 3. Obstacle 3 is the weighted lunges. You are required to do a total of 20 repetition. Alright, that is alternating the right leg and the left leg. So you go 10 on the right, 10 on the left. So you need to say you go 1, switch, 2, switch, 3, all the way until you hit 20. Okay, so that's the requirement. Alright, so not gonna waste time. I'm just gonna show you guys as I explain to you guys the requirement of this movement. Yeah? So first thing first, the weight requirement is the same as the overhead press, the very first obstacle. So in my case, I'm just going to show you guys an example of using my dumbbell. And as mentioned, also the requirement of the obstacle, you are not allowed to hold it above your shoulder. So holding it in this position will not be allowed, so you want to hold it by the side. Yeah. Okay, so a tip that I can give to you guys, the other thing is try and find a place where you actually have a significant lunge. In my case, like, I'm using my bench, right? So I'm just going to step outside my bench. I'm using this way because once I step forward and I step back, I'm going to just step outside my bench and get back to the same position. Okay, and then Yes. So the other thing is to actually film yourself from sideways. So I can so the person who's gonna verify your video will be able to see that your knees are less than 90 degrees. Okay, so that is actually the requirement. You need to be 90 degrees or less. So here's also another tip I'm gonna give you guys shortly. Yeah? So just take a look first, let me do this quickly for you guys. I'm gonna do forward. Okay, so if you guys notice when I actually do this movement, I actually purposely bring my knees to the ground. Okay, so the reason why I do that is so because you are going to be tired. You're not going to be able to look at yourself whether you're going to be ending up 90 degrees. Because every single time you're just going to try and estimate doing a movement, you will actually not hit 90 degrees, especially when you're trying. Trust me on this. So, what, as I mentioned, what you want to do is bring your knees down to the ground, up, back to the same start position, stand tall, up. There you go, I already completed 2 reps just like that. Okay, so this is me using the dumbbell. As mentioned also, you are allowed to use other equipments. You just need to be creative, as long as the weight is the same as the first obstacle. So in my case, just now I show you as an example of using it with a kettlebell, right? I'm going to do the same thing. The thing I need to take note of is make sure both hands are supporting the weight. So in my case, I'm going to hold the kettlebell this way. Okay, and this is not above my shoulder, as you guys can see. Alright, so I'll hold. Okay, so this is just an alternative equipment. Okay, movement is the same, everything is the same. Okay, there you go, that is the lunges. So number 4, and it's called the jumping jacks with hands-free push-ups. Okay, so the requirement is you have to do 10 jumping jacks followed by 1 hands-free push-ups, and you do that a total of 3 times. Okay, 3 rounds, 3 times, 3 sets, or whatever you want to call it. So in total you should be doing 30 jumping jacks and 3 hands-free push-ups. Okay, so I'm gonna just quickly show you guys. Okay, so jumping jacks, very straightforward. Some of you guys, most of you guys probably have done this before. If you guys have not, it's fine. And of course, there's a lot of variation to the jumping jack. But the requirement for the jumping jack now is very simple. You're gonna start with your hands by the side. Okay, and then when you come up, you're gonna bring your hands up over your head. As you do that, you're gonna jump up to the side. Just like that. Okay, and then you go back down to the side again. Okay, so you're gonna count all the way until you hit 10. Okay, once you hit 10, you're gonna go down. Hands, free push up is the requirement you need to do is you're gonna raise your hands up, you're gonna raise your legs up, okay, and then push up, and then same thing, continue. 1, 2, 10, and then go down again. Okay, and same thing, and the last one will be you doing the push-ups, and then once you stand up, straight away run for your next obstacle. Okay, so there you go. Jumping jacks with hands-free push-ups. So the last obstacle, the side-to-side push-up. Okay, so for the side-to-side push-up, you are required to do a total of 10 repetitions, 5 side each. You will need an object that's about 5 cm or 2 inches. And make sure you verify that. So in my case, I'm actually using my dumbbell as an object for today. Alright, so let's quickly show you guys how the movement is supposed to be done. And I'm just going to show you guys a couple of repetitions. Okay, let's just, I'm going to show you guys 2 on each side. Yeah? So you do something like this. Okay, so as you guys can see, that's the side-to-side push-up. First thing I need you guys to take note is you want to make sure you start this movement at the top, yeah? So with your hands straightened out at the top. Okay, the other thing I will strongly suggest, find an object that is wide enough. Okay, so let's say I'm using an object that is very small, or maybe I'm just using 1 dumbbell. Okay, when I want to do the transfer, that will be an issue. So as you guys can see, what I will do is I will actually place my hand on this side, so when I transfer, the other hand will be here. Okay, so from the top, you want to start with everything straight, arm straight,
straight, okay? And then when you lower yourself down, remember, chest touches the ground. You don't have to raise your hands up, but you got to make sure that your chest touches the ground. So when you press up, transfer your hand to the other side, same thing, chest touches the ground. Okay? And the very important thing, when you finish, just make sure if let's say I go 1, 2, 3, all the way until I hit my 10 rep, right? So at this position, I got to make sure I press up. That will be counted as the 10 rep. So once you're done, quickly stand up and then you continue with your rep. Okay, so alternatively, for the open and the kids category, you guys are allowed to perform this movement with your knees on the ground. Okay, so yeah, I would strongly suggest also, if you are doing this movement, just make sure position it in an angle where they can actually see your chest touches the ground and they can also see your object importantly. Alright, that's it. Okay guys, so there you have it, all the 5 obstacles for the World OCR Virtual Race 3. Okay, so I hope it has helped you guys answer your uncertainties and stuff like that. But then again, I'm very sure that there might be still some questions or some of you guys are still unsure of certain things. So please feel free, just do text us and we're gonna try and get back to you guys as soon as possible. Okay, so I hope you guys have a good race, and if there's anything, as always, I will always mention, please stay safe, stay strong, and don't forget to wear your mask. I think that's also another important thing I need to tell you guys. Alright guys, take care.